When working with database, schema migration is one important task that we often have to do throughout the application lifetime to adapt to new business requirements. In this lecture, we will learn how to write and run database schema migration in Golang. For that, we're going to use golang-migrate library. This library works with many different database engines, like Postgres, MySQL, Mongo, or Cockroach. Let's open this CLI documentation to see how to install it. I'm on a Mac, so I will use homebrew. Let's open the terminal and run brew install golang-migrate. While waiting for homebrew to install the package, let's take a look at the usage guide. Migrate gives us several commands. The first one is create, which we can use to create new migration files. The second one is go to, which will migrate the schema to a specific version. Then the up or down command to apply all or any up or down migrations. There are several more commands, but in most of the time, we will work with create up and down commands. Alright, migrate is successfully installed. Let's check its version with migrate version. It's 4.11.0. We can run migrate help to read its manual. Okay, now I'm going to create a new folder for our simple bank project. And inside, I will create a new folder, DB migration, to store all of our migration files. Then let's create the first migration file to initialize our simple bank's database schema. Start with migrate create. Then the extension of the file will be SQL, and the directory to store it is DB migration. We use a seq flag to generate a sequential version number for the migration file. And finally, the name of the migration, which is init schema in this case. Two migration files have been generated for us. They both have version 1 in the file name's prefix, but their suffixes are different. One file is up and the other is down. Why? Well, basically, it's a best practice when writing database migration. The up script is run to make a forward change to the schema, and the down script is run if we want to revert the change made by the up script. So when we run migrate up command, the up script files inside the DB migration folder will be run sequentially by the order of their prefix version. On the contrary, when we run migrate down command, the down script files inside the DB migration folder will be run sequentially by the reverse order of their prefix version. Alright, now let's open the simplebank.sql file that we've generated in the previous lecture. I'm going to copy all content of this file and paste it to the initschema.up.sql file. For the initschema.down.sql file, we should revert the changes made by the up script. In this case, the up script creates three tables, account, transfers, and entries. So the down script should remove all of them. We use a drop table query for this purpose. And here we drop entries and transfers table before dropping the account table, because there's a foreign key constraint in entries and transfers that references account records. Okay, so now our migration scripts are ready. Let's try to run them. But before that, we should check if the Postgres container is still running or not with the docker ps command. Okay, it's still running. By the way, I'm going to show you some more docker commands to work with containers. If we want to stop a running container, we use docker stop with the container name or ID. After this, if we run docker ps, we don't see the Postgres container anymore because it's not running. We can run docker ps-a to list all containers, regardless of their running status. Now we see our Postgres container with status exited. To turn it back on, we just need to run docker start and pass in the container name or ID. Then here we go, the Postgres trial container is now up and running. We can access its shell with the docker exec command. As we are using Postgres unpied image, we don't have bash shell as in Ubuntu, so we use bin sh shell instead. Inside the shell, we have access to all standard Linux commands. And since this is a Postgres container, it also gives us some CLI commands to interact with Postgres server directly from the shell. Let's use the createDB command to create a new database for our simple bank. We use the username option to say that we are connecting as root user, and the owner option to say that the database we are going to create will belong to root user as well. And the last argument is the database name, simple bank. Okay, the database is created. Let's try to access its console with the PSQL command. Cool, it works. We can also delete the database using dropdb command. We use exit command to get out the container shell. Now from outside of the container, we can run createDB directly with the docker exec command and access the database console without going through the container shell. Okay, now I'm going to create a makefile in our project, then add a createDB command to create the simple bank database. And also a dropdb command to delete it. When working in a team, this command will be useful for your teammate to easily set up the project on their local machine for development. Let's look for the command that we used to start Postgres container in the previous lecture and add it to the makefile as well. Alright, now let's stop the current Postgres container. The container is stopped. I'm going to remove it completely using the docker remove command. Okay, it's gone. Now when we run make Postgres, a new Postgres container will be started. And we can run make createDB to create the simple bank database. So the DB is created. Let's connect to it using table plus. The connection that we've set up in the previous lecture will bring us to the root database. We can click on this icon to open our new simple bank database. Alright, now you can see two databases here, root and simple bank. For now, the simple bank database is empty, so let's go back to the terminal and run the first migration. Start with migrate. Then we use the path option to specify the folder contains our migration files, which is db migration. Then the database option to specify the URL to the database server. We are using Postgres, so the driver name is PostgreSQL. Then the username is root. The password is secret. The address is localhost, port 5432. And the database name is simple bank. We use the verbose option to ask migrate to print verbose login. Finally, we use the up argument to tell migrate to run migrate up. Oh, we've got an error. SSL is not enabled on the server. That's because our Postgres container doesn't enable SSL by default. So we should add SSL mode equal disable parameter to the database URL. And the migration is successful. If we refresh the simple bank database in table plus, we can now see four tables: account, entries, transfers, and schema migrations. The schema migrations table stores the latest applied migration version. In our case, it is version 1 because we have run only one single migration file. The dirty column tells us if the last migration has failed or not. If it fails, we must manually fix the issues to make the database state clean before trying to run any other migration versions. Okay, now I'm going to add the migrate up command to the make file. Let's add the migrate down command as well. Then add the migrate up and migrate down to the phony list. Now let's try them in the terminal. First, I will run make migrate down. Go back to table plus and refresh. All tables are gone, except for the schema migrations table. Okay, now let's run make migrate up. Then refresh table plus. All tables are back again. So that wraps up today's lecture about database migration. Thank you for watching and see you in the next lecture.